Good morning, everyone. So today is the third day, and this is SRCC versus Maharaja Agrasen. This is the last day of the league matches. As you can see on the screen, Maharaja Agrasen, SRCC. SRCC football team together. Those who are watching, if you have any suggestions or recommendations, you can send that to us on our NCFL page, Facebook.
So now, the two team huddles, ready with the initial battle cry. On the left, you have SRCC in blue, and on the right, you have Maharaja Agrasen in red and black. SRCC have had a mixed run until now. Yesterday, this turned out to be a wonderful outing for SRCC. When they defeated Venki from coming from behind, and with that whistle, we are kicked off. We have the kickoff. As I was saying, Maharaja Agrasen haven't had the best of starts to this league. They've lost both their matches. They'll be, even though the chances of them making it to the final four are very slim, almost zero, they'll be hoping to salvage some of their pride by winning this match. Coming to SRCC, they're still in the hunt and will be looking to make it to the final four by winning this match, assuring their position in one of the final four.
into the night. I raise my hand to the fire, but it's no use, 'cause you can't stop it from shining through. It's true, baby, let the light shine through.
That could have been an opportunity for Maharaj Agrasen if they had grabbed it, but I think the striker persisted with the ball too long without passing it, and eventually the ball ended up with the goalkeeper. It was a reasonable chance. Initial jitter for SRCC camp over here. The coach animated. That was a brilliant goal by the SRCC, the opener today. Good coordination and a cheeky pass there from SRCC centre forward, culminating in the goal. They've taken the lead. But this could also be a danger find. There's an equaliser within a minute for MSC, for Maharaja Agrasen. And it's lax defense, proving costly for the SRCC team here. That goal actually proved to be a dampener for SRCC. It's a lofty attempt. Straight from the midfield. Some exciting moments here. Two goals within the span of a minute from both the teams. First one by SRCC and an equalizer later by MSC. This is a That is a goal again. Wonderful corner kick by the SRCC. And the blunder by the MSC keeper, who deflected the ball onto the goal post. Well, the pendulum has again turned towards SRCC here. Well, it's turning rather wildly from one direction to the other. Well, this is exciting stuff. Three goals within a span of 2 minutes. Oh, the ball is out of reach. And that seems to be clumsy from MSC defense and the keeper. But for the corner was not that great. It was straight to the keeper. If he had grabbed onto the ball, it would have been just another corner missed attempt. But, you know, slippy fingers. Couldn't hold on to the ball. Was a brave attempt there. We'll be right back.
Thank you.
life.
Well, these scenes actually hide the fact that there was just a goal now from SRCC, and followed by some clash between the goalkeeper and the forward. But nevertheless, SRCC now lead by 2 goals. The score reads 3-1. The last half an hour saw some intense competition between both the teams, but SRCC is slightly enjoying an upper hand, and that's reflected in the scoreline. This is again an incredible opportunity for SRCC. This could be spelled danger for. Whoa. It was a very good attempt. Some gaping holes in the MAC defense. Well, that was another opportunity for SRCC. Still, they enjoy a good lead, and we hope to carry that lead to the end of the match.
Hello, so that was the first half, which saw SRCC dominate Maharaj Agrasen 3-1. In the middle, there were a couple of minutes which saw the pendulum shifting in the favor of the two teams, from SRCC to MAC and back to SRCC. So it's a 10-minute break and we'll be back after the break. Meanwhile, we play for you the promo videos which we had made for the Center College. Hope you enjoy it.
काफ़ी बार चैंपियन रहे हैं इंटर कॉलेज के और टीम ने हमारी कंसिस्टेंट परफॉर्मेंस दी है क्योंकि हमारा प्रैक्टिस पूरे साल कंटिन्यूस हम लोग प्रैक्टिस करते हैं 8 प्लेयर्स हमारे यूनिवर्सिटी रिप्रेजेंट किया है तो थोड़ा एक्सपीरियंस वाइज मैं कहता हूँ थोड़ा सा ज़्यादा होगा प्लेयर्स के पास टीम के चैम्पियन हम लोग को थोड़ा प्रेशर तो रहता ही कि भाई क्योंकि एक जगह पर बने रहना या फर्स्ट पोजिशन पर रहना अपने आप में काफ़ी बड़ी अचीवमेंट होती है तो हम कोशिश करेंगे उस चीज़ को मेंटेन करें इस साल भी
there's pressure as well as confidence in our team like we have to defend the title for the fourth time there are some weaknesses in the team that our coaches are helping us and basically our strength is fitness most of our teammates have been passed last year so we have a fresh batch this season lads are doing pretty well and I hope they do pretty well in future also so let's hope for the best for the upcoming tournament
bol bhai jangal ki
jay jay
Boys have been working really, really hard now for the best part of 6 months now. Last year we stood third, and the year prior to that we were runners-up, and we are only looking to better that performance. Hopefully, we are the champions this time.
Last 3 years we are in the top 4, but somehow we missed the last spot. Last year we semi-final में मेरे हिसाब से तो हम लोग unfortunate थे because we missed the penalty in the matches and we missed also so many opportunities. But this year the boys are really gearing up. So most probably they will give their best shot in the tournament and hopefully we will achieve our target.
So the team is practicing well now. Some of our good players passed out last year. So we've made a new team this year and we've not been able to play the knockout stages. I would say a disadvantage this year because we need to know our potential. We've not been knowing our potential till now. We'll play practice matches now. So let's see how we'll perform this year.
Things have changed now, right? Your warm-up should be dynamic. You are doing your ground exercise, running mein hi karna hai. Stretch karna hai. Ruk ke kuch nahi karna. Aur jitna zyada ho sake ball ke saath.
इफेक्ट ही अच्छी हो रही है रेस करें टूर्नामेंट का कब स्टार्ट हो जोर शोर से चल इफेक्ट अच्छी चल रही है आई होप कि कुछ अच्छा करें कॉलेज में कॉलेज में
Out of 44 teams, we are like last four. Delhi University के जो fixture है ना, जिस तरह से हम लोग काम करते हैं, continuous रहता है. Three matches like in league, you have to play continuously. So उसमें कुछ injury हो गया था like players को. So this year like I am focusing in कि जो भी player मेरा रहे लगा है लगे, district for that like playing three matches in 3 days. और changes मेरे पास हैं, I can change. I have a good strength in bench.
First phase of our inter-college went very good. We won 4 out of 4 matches and our strikers are scoring goals, midfield is creating chances and now the quarters begins, we have to face the defending champions. They continue on the inter-college for 3 times and we got many players from Motilal only. So we are focusing on it and individual fitness and shooting so we can perform well.
Welcome back to the second half of this very exciting match between SRCC and Maharaj Agrasen. From the looks of it, it looks like SRCC will win this match, which gives them 6 points to go tie with Zakir Hussain in this group. The next match between Zakir Hussain and Winky, this is the match between the two semi-finalists of the previous season. Zakir Hussain, the semi-finalist, and Winky, the runners-up. That match will decide the fate of Winky. Zakir Hussain as of now looks pretty happy at the top of the table with 6 points, winning 2 out of 2 games. But Winky is a tough opponent. But as of now, let's focus on the game we have on the cards right now. That's SRCC and Maharaj Agrasen. There were a couple of minutes in the 10th or 11th minute starting, which saw 3 goals being scored by SRCC, Maharaj Agrasen and SRCC respectively. Pretty sloppy defense by Maharaj Agrasen. It's a shame that their defense hasn't been able to look out for the strikers. And a lot of times they have been losing possession. So the referees are on the field. The whistle is about to blow. Teams in a huddle. Maharaj Agrasen will start this half. The strikers ready at the half line. And there we have it. The timer starts. That was really lucky there for Maharaj Agrasen. No defense at all, and again there's sloppy work by the defense. And here we have a goal. Finally, Just 3 minutes into the second half, SRCC scores once again. I don't know, Maharaja Agrasen, maybe this is the third day in a row that the players are playing, and it's the fitness levels which is taking a toll on the players. Even yesterday we saw a lot of players getting injured, a lot of time being lost because of that. It's really difficult to have a fitness wherein you could play for 3 straight days in the scorching sun, 90 minute games. And they have a corner kick now, SRCC. They have already converted a corner before. And another goal. The entire defense line of Maharaja Agrasen seems to be confused. Nobody seems to be knowing where the players are, where the ball is, where this match is going for that reason. To our viewers, kindly let us know how many goals do you think SRCC will score in this match. You could tweet to us your answer. The lucky winners, well, we don't have anything else, but we will definitely let our viewers know who the lucky winners is. You can tweet to us @_NCFL is the Twitter handle. Well, if you ask me, my personal guess would be 8. None of the matches in intercollege this season has seen 8 goals being scored by a team, and I would really want SRCC to break that.
In the sky, gazing far into the night, I raise my hand to the fire, but it's no use, 'cause you can't stop it from shining through. It's true, baby, let the light shine through. If you believe it's true, baby, won't you let the light shine through for you. We'll be right back.
in the sky, gazing far into the night. I raise my hand to the fire, but it's no use, 'cause you can't stop it from shining through. It's true, baby, let the light shine through. If you believe it's true, baby, won't you let the light. We'll be right back.
that's the sixth goal for SRCC. Seventh goal of the day, sixth for SRCC. SRCC really looking to have a goal advantage in case Zakir Hussain gets defeated by Winky. In that case, there will be two teams, SRCC. There will be three teams, in fact, SRCC, Zakir and Winky, all with 6 points apiece. And the two teams which qualify through to the semi-finals will be decided on the basis of the goal difference. And SRCC seems to have an edge if it comes to that. Unless in the rest of the 30 minutes, Maharaja Agrasen pulls something really magical off.
We'll be right back.
So somehow here Maharaja Agrasen managing to the ball inside SRCC's half. And we have the scoreline as 7-2. Well, I still hope SRCC can score one more goal in the remaining 8 minutes and make it 8-2, which obviously makes it this double digit scoring match, the first in the Center College. And the interesting thing has been that none of the goals has been in penalty. All the 9 goals scored have been field goals or corners. Players from Venki were seen cheering for Maharaja Agrasen because a huge goal difference will put a lot of pressure on Venki. So the strategy for Venki here is pretty clear. Attack, attack, attack. From the time the whistle blows, we'll see Venki attacking Zakir Hussain. Okay. So let's see how this game progresses.
So as you can see, there are 7 minutes left for this match. SRCC leading 7 goals to 2 against MAC Maharaja Agrasen College. The next match is between Shivaji and Zakir Hussain. I beg your pardon. It's Zakir Hussain versus Venki. It's a Group 1 league match. As you can see on screen, Maharaja Agrasen is attacking well right now. Playing very aggressive in the last 10 minutes. I hope you are enjoying this match. And now SRCC, and very well defended by the goalkeeper. Maharaja Agrasen needs to do a lot in terms of goal score. SRCC attacking again. And this would be a goal kick. You can also see the highlights of the matches in our NCFL page, Facebook page, and also in our YouTube channel, North Campus Football League. Position wise, you can see that Maharaja Agrasen is doing well, pretty well in the second half.
changes.
Almost 4 minutes of game left. SRCC on the attack, but very futile pass. No forward came to take the ball. Dangerous for Maharaja Agrasen. It's a very good pass through, but it's called offside. Now, hope you enjoy the music. SRCC leads 8-2 against MEC. A very beautiful goal you just saw on the screen.
No.
Our cameraman is also very excited, Mr. Nakul Harur, who sometimes get the mic and do the commentary. You will hear him in the next match also. So in the next match we have Zakir Hussain playing against Venki. It's the last match of Group 1. It's the last league match of Group 1. MAC must be thinking what they can do now. They lag 6 goals behind. Last few minutes of the game left. Score says it all. 8-2. SRCC wins the match. Eight to two, and the next match will be Zakir Hussain versus Venki. We will be live back within 10 minutes.